Salutations, friends. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be reviewing Benigna Parfums. This is absolute celebration. I've been in love with this fragrance and I wanted to review it for you guys specifically as we get into fall because I think this is a masterpiece that's just really going to open and bloom in the slightly brisker weather. So if you'd like to know what I think, then keep watching. For transparency purposes, this fragrance was sent to me to review, so that is where I got it. This is a house that I've been kind of really intrigued by. The name is Cécile Zarrochia, and she has worked. I love what she's done with Amouage. I loved what she's done with Jacques Vaughan. She's created some amazing fragrances for MDCI and Nichene, and just she is a fantastic, fantastic nose. So I was really excited to try this fragrance, see what she created. And this is a luxury fragrance. Their presentation is quite opulent. You got Swarovski crystals, you got a gold-plated cap, some hand-cut crystal cap. The entire presentation of this does look like it's an expensive bottle, and this is a very expensive bottle. So for 15 mil, you're looking at spending about $115. For 75 mil USD, it's just under $500. It's $495. So this is a luxury fragrance, and it is a luxury price. Now they do have this unique trio set where you get less fragrance, but the whole presentation is really fantastic. I've been eyeing that because I think it looks just really cute and also really beautiful presentation. So the notes in this scent are Bulgarian rose, there's orris, there's peach, there's oud. You also have some neroli, musks, and sandalwood, and ambergris. Now, Absolute Celebration is a shared fragrance, and it is described as a fruity and bright floral. But what I love most about this fragrance is less of the fruitiness and more of the floral. Now, I did a review or a list talking about the fragrances for fall, and this was one of the more higher priced ones. And the reason being is there's something about the neroli and the musk that just works and creates this beautiful brightness. Now this is a fruity floral fragrance, but none of this is fruity, like smells like Fruity Loops. And the florals are definitely more aromatic and less kind of leaning women's designer fragrance florals, like Too Sweet Jasmine, Creamy Tuberoses. There is rose in here and neroli and orris and ambergris and peach, and all these things can come together and create a really beautiful, fruity, sparkly, flirty fragrance, but that's not what this is. And I actually enjoy the fact that this is more musky and has a beautiful, and I mean very deep green neroli essence to it, which works with everything else. Rose is slightly sweet. It's a big, beautiful Bulgarian rose. I enjoy the slight kiss of musk in here with the neroli. That is what really predominantly, at least on my skin, is center stage, but you get some fruitiness from peach. You get some beautiful complexity from the orris, and the sandalwood is there too. But what I like about this fragrance is that it smells crisp and bright and dazzling, like a cut gem. And I like that because I like the idea of something not being sweet, not being fruity, not being too floral, but at the same time has a lot of the beautiful characteristics that go along with that. So you get the kind of the flavor of peach without the sweetness, beautiful essence of neroli without it being too overpowering. And with the peach and neroli, it could come off kind of tutti frutti orange blossom, but it doesn't. Everything works in harmony to create this really very complex, very wearable fragrance that I think smells kind of just perfect for fall. And a lot of times when you're looking at fall fragrances, everybody recommends gourmands. I understand. I love wearing gourmand fragrances, or really heavy tobacco, or really heavy oud, or really heavy leather, or these heavier, more decadent, more gooey fragrances. And I do love to wear those scents. But sometimes people prefer lighter, fresher, more dazzling fragrances that still will handle the cold, crisp weather of fall. And that's what this fragrance ultimately really does. This fragrance has that beautiful neroli and that greenness and that brightness, but the neroli is slightly bitter, just a little bit like bitter orange. And that bitterness, I think, will translate beautifully to fall, especially if you prefer more dazzling, more effervescent, more uplifting fragrances, and you find that some of those fragrances that you really enjoy wearing don't work in colder weather. That's where Absolute Celebration really shines. This is an all-weather, all-year type of fragrance, even though it is lighter. In winter time, again, that neroli and that musk is gonna be a little bit too light for I would say, super cold weather. The addition of oud and the addition of this peach and this rose help it be more substantial, help it have more presence to where it's going to work in colder weather. And so if you like lighter, fresher, very dazzling, very complex fragrances in spring and summer, this is not a heavy fragrance. You could wear this year round. But at the same time, if you prefer to wear those types of fragrances year round and you live in a type of environment where it gets too cold and sometimes those fragrances get lost, this is a great fragrance, specifically in fall. I think it's going to be a beautiful fragrance to wear when it gets to be like a cozy sweater wearing season. So it's just a beautiful complexity to it. Again, the neroli and the musk is just magic on the skin. It's bright, it's green, it's uplifting, it's slightly bitter. Everything else works to just really elevate everything else. It's a beautiful symphony, and at the end of the day, it's been a gorgeous fragrance that I've really loved wearing. Now, this is luxury priced fragrance. Again, for this size bottle, you're looking at spending $495 USD. So a lot of people will want to know about performance. How does it perform in regards to longevity and sillage? Now with this fragrance, I do get a really nice performance. I get about 6 hours on my skin, which if you know where I live is pretty fantastic. This fragrance isn't so beastly, but it does have a moderate sillage. You're going to be able to smell it with social distancing, but it's going to be very light and wispy, and that's something that I enjoy. I feel like if this was too loud, you would kind of lose the nuances. I like that this, you can smell this social distancing far away, but it's light and airy and kind of more alluring and enticing. Now, this does have a lot of notes that people might think women's fragrance in regards to how it smells, but this is a definitively shared fragrance, like right down the middle. I find that the neroli essence and this beautiful musk kind of basically play it and hold it and anchor it down in the middle. It's light, it's airy, it's green, it's brisk, it's uplifting, it's sparkling, it's dazzling, but it's got a tiny bit of sweetness and a tiny bit of woodiness, and they just kind of balance each other out really beautifully. End of the day, this is a really beautiful fragrance. The presentation is definitely something that you are paying for when you purchase this bottle of perfume, and it is a ridiculously beautiful, this is a very opulent presentation in regards to the bottle and the box that you get with it. It's definitely experience, and I really enjoy that. But at the end of the day, do I think that this juice is worth $495? And to be perfectly honest, I do. You don't need to have a heavy, decadent fragrance that just drips of like resins and woods. Sometimes the beauty is in the quality ingredients and them being expertly blended and balanced. And Cecile has done an amazing job. Again, she is an expert. I love her creation. She's one of my favorite noses. And this is definitely something you should get your nose on if you are looking for a fragrance to wear in fall that's not a stereotypical fall fragrance. If you like those greener, those fresher, those most crisp, dazzling fragrances, I think you're really going to enjoy this. Anyway, guys, that is my review of Absolute Celebration. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you had the opportunity to try this fragrance, I'd love to know what you think. Let me know in the comment section below. As always, guys, I hope you're all happy and healthy and have a great day, month, year, whatever, and I'll see you next time.